It's Think Museums once again, and we are in Virginia City one more time to check out St. Mary's in the Mountains Catholic Church and Museum. This structure was built in the 1870s, survived a firebreak, and is still standing strong. Wow, this is beautiful. I never expected this. You know, I didn't expect the building that, you know, when they talked about the being constructed in the 1860s, you know, I didn't expect it to look so beautiful and magnificent like this. But this looks, you know, beautiful and very welcoming and warm inside. And I just like the workmanship that has been done here in terms of, you know, the carpenters doing the roofing and all that. This is classical. This is a nice, wonderful job they did here. And I like the windows. I like the staining on the window. It's really bringing in some beautiful light inside this church. One thing I noticed here is that they have a lot of icons. You know, they have a lot of saints, you know. I guess this is some of the people have done wonderful things here in this church. In the entrance, I just saw some images of the Pope, of the different popes, you know. Yeah, and that is the what we have there. That's the pulpit. That's where they have the father. That's, they call fathers, the priest. Up there, they have a piece of art. That's up high, but we can see it. It looks beautiful. But this is nice. You know, yeah, this is nicely done. It's beautiful. It's not that big. It's a tiny church. And I was just wondering, why would they have a Catholic church out here in the Old West, you know, in a mining town for the miners? And I'm just, you know, thinking that maybe it had to do with some of the immigrants that were coming to this area. And notice that, you know, most of the names of even the priests were, the priests and all that, they had some Irish roots. So I suppose there was a big, when they discovered silver here in Virginia City, they had a big population of immigrants from Irish immigrants that came here. And I think that's why the church was set up here. And they said this is the oldest church in Nevada, you know. So it's like the cradle of Catholicism. You know, it's like the starting point of where Catholicism started here in Nevada. So it's important. It has some historical significance. Well, that's how it is. Well, I mean, I'm going to try and, you know, show you as much as possible. And just to let you know, in the basement down here, there's a museum that has all the collections from all the years, you know, stored down there. And they have it as an exhibition. So we'll also be going to check it out. This building was, this church was burnt down during the Great Fire in the 1870s. So they saved a lot of the objects and artifacts which had been, you know, preserved in the basement in their museum. So we'll check that one too. And also just to let you know, this month I'm trying to focus on a lot of museums in Virginia City, Reno area. In the next couple of months, I'm going to be doing other museums in California. In case you have not subscribed to this channel, please subscribe so you don't miss on the museums that I'll be visiting in the next couple of months. So if you're a Catholic believer, you can buy some stuff that you can take with you. But what they have here is just, you know, most of the stuff they have here is in relation to Catholic Church. Please subscribe and let's make this channel grow. And if you have any suggestion of any other museums that you'd like me to visit in Northern Nevada and Northern California, please let me know so I can, you know, try and check them out and put them out for you. Again, thank you very much at the St. Mary's in the Mountains Catholic Church. Just bringing to you what this museum, this church, its historical significance, and to the people of Virginia City. So please subscribe and let's connect. We'll be right back.